If you like your music to sound just right, then you're probably going to want to use the Equalizer, both in iTunes on your Mac and also in the Music app on your iOS device. To access the Equalizer in iTunes on your Mac, simply go to the Window menu and bring up Equalizer. And notice the keyboard shortcut is Option Command E. So the Equalizer is this little window, and it kind of looks like an old-fashioned stereo equalizer with sliders that you can move up and down. Now, first you have to turn it on to use it at all. So you want to turn on the on switch. Then you can select from all these presets. So these are some general presets, and you're going to find the same set in iOS. So if you can find something you like here, that's probably best. Otherwise, you could go to manual, and then you could adjust these as you like. Matter of fact, if you start with one, say you're going to start with rock, you can also adjust from there, and it switches to manual. So you can change everything in here, and if you like the settings, you like how it sounds, then you can hit Make Preset and give it a name. You can also edit the list and rename any of these or delete them. You're probably going to want to leave the defaults there and just create your own ones, because as I'm going to show you, you're going to use those defaults on iOS anyway. Now you also have the ability to add on a per song basis. So for instance, if we look at an individual song, so let's select a song here, or I can select a group of songs. So let's select this entire album here. And I'll use Command I to bring up information for all these songs. I go to Options, and there is a setting for Equalizer. And I can choose any of the presets plus any ones I've added. So I added Rock Plus, that's mine, but the rest of these are the defaults in iTunes. So you can only select one of these. You can't custom set one here. So you want to set it in Equalizer first, create a preset, and then you can select it here. This allows you to say take all of your rock songs or a particular rock album and set it to rock, and then take say a classical album and set that to classical, and it won't affect the rest of your settings. So in iOS it's very different. So we're going to look here on an iPad, but it's basically the same for the iPhone. You use the Music app, of course, to play music, not iTunes in iOS, but the Equalizer is actually going to be in Settings. So we'll go to Settings, and we'll look for Music. And under Music, you can see the EQ under Playback. So we'll go into there. And here you can set it to any of the defaults. You can't create your own. You can't customize it. So you have to choose one of these. Now you do have the ability, if you're syncing your songs from iTunes on your Mac to your iOS device, to set custom equalizer settings for different songs. But they have to be one of the defaults. So you can set it to rock, classical, or something like that for a specific song. And when they sync, then those settings will come through on your device. But you can't view them and you can't alter them here. And you also need to actually have the equalizer turned on. So if it's off, it'll be off for everything. If you turn it to flat, flat is basically like turning it on but not using it, then the songs will have their own custom settings. But in general, you basically have one setting. So you might want to get used to going into the Settings app and changing it for the type of music you want to hear. So as far as what settings work best, well, it's very subjective. It depends on you and also your equipment, your speaker system or your headphones, and then of course what your personal preferences are. So if you want to try it out, you want to experiment, maybe listen to the same song and keep switching between them just to see what it is you like, and it may be that you simply just don't like using it at all, or maybe you find a setting that really fits some of your favorite music. Thank you.